My name is Dhananjay Mohan and I work in the Wildlife Institute of India. One of the important projects I am doing right now looks at the differences in the bird species numbers and densities in East and West Himalayas. We all know there is a gradient of density and diversity across the Himalayas, with Eastern Himalayas supporting far too many species as compared to Western Himalayas. And we are aware of some broad reasons behind that, but this project explores deeply into the possible ecological and historical reasons behind these differences. Eastern Himalayas, as you know, are perhaps the second most diverse place when it comes to bird diversity in the entire world, only next to some places in South America. And as you move along the Himalayas, although it's a continuum, the number of species drops to less than half. So that is what really intrigued us, and we designed this project. So as a part of this project, we are working across the entire length of Himalayas, right from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. And we follow certain methodology for our work. And one of the most important things that we do is we lay 5-hectare grids at different altitudes and in along the length of Himalayas in all the Himalayan states. And we try to count all the species on that 5-hectare plot. This we do by mapping the birds and spending around 3 mornings, about 5 hours on 3 consecutive mornings. And that is how we are able to count each and every individual of all the birds. And this is what is giving us some important, interesting findings already, although we are yet to get into full-scale analysis of our data. But the diversity of birds is peaking at mid-altitudes in around 1,000 meters in both East and West Himalayas. So that is a general similarity, and it has definitely declined as expected on the Western Himalayas. The project gives us a lot of opportunity to spend time in the beautiful forests across the Himalayas, particularly Eastern Himalayas. Any bird watcher or anybody interested in birds, it's a heaven for him or her. And we're fortunate to spend about a month every year for the last 3 years. This is the third year of our field data collection. And like this year, we've already spent about 3 weeks in Eastern Himalayas, starting from Baksa in North Bengal, and then we moved over to Meghalaya, and now for the last 1 week we are in Arunachal Pradesh, in fairly eastern part of Arunachal Pradesh, which is called Mishmi Hills. A lot of birds seen here are not seen elsewhere in the country, and so it's really exciting to see them, watch them. And it's quite challenging actually to watch them, because they are always hiding in dense bushes, and it's just to get a glimpse of them requires a lot of patience, a lot of effort. But once you do that, and it's really rewarding if you get a sight of, say, a black-throated parrotbill or a beautiful sepia. It's really, really, very heartening for anybody who's interested in birds, particularly such exotic birds. So we hope that in the next couple of years we'll be able to come up with some interesting findings explaining the reasons behind differences in bird species numbers and densities in East and West Himalayas. We are also going to start from this year a component where we are going to look at the genetic differences between the populations in East and West Himalayas, because there could be a historical angle. I mean, birds may have reached Eastern Himalayas, may have got more time to evolve in Eastern Himalayas, which could be one of the possible reasons why we have a higher diversity here. So in the next couple of years, we'll try to get more field data and do analysis and come to the results which we are looking forward to.